Hello and welcome to Beard Power. Today I'll be discussing common terminology in Excel. As always, if you like this video, please like it. Subscribe for further content in the future. Click this little bell icon to all. That way you'll be notified when I make a new video. First term is workbook. That's your entire Excel spreadsheet. The next one is the worksheet, that's the current sheet that you're on. You can also toggle through your sheets on the bottom left corner. Starting back at the top, we have your file title. This is whatever you decide to save your workbook as. Next, we have the search bar. We can consider this the help menu and your username. Below that, you have your tabs. So you got your home tab, insert tab, page layout tab. You click into a tab that opens up your ribbon. Within your ribbon, you have multiple different groups. As you can see, we have a font group, alignment group, number group. You'll notice this little button in the bottom right corner of the groups. If you open that, that will give you more options that they were unable to fit within the group. Below that is the quick access toolbar, my favorite place in Excel. In my next tutorial, I'll be going over an in-depth analysis on how this is the time saver. Now we're going to jump into the spreadsheet itself. Spreadsheet is made up of columns and rows. The intersection of a row and a column is a cell, and each cell has its own name. This one here is C5. And this is shown in your name box on the top left corner below your quick access toolbar. The next thing we're going to look at is a range of cells. Now that is any grouping of cells. That could be this, or a big group like that, or like this. Basically any number of cells that are grouped together. Just like clicking into a cell and you can see C5, you can actually name a group as well. The way that you would do that is you go C5 through E8. The way that you would write that is C5 through, the symbol for through is a colon, type in E8. And that shows your range within the formula bar. Okay, so I added some sample data so we can go through the remaining terms. First off, we'll go within the spreadsheet on the very top. Is your headers, and right to the bottom you have something called a status bar. It'll give you your average, count, sum. Next we have borders. These are the solid lines in between your cells. I'm going to change my spreadsheet into a table. Loads of benefits to a table. I'll cover this in a separate tutorial. Next we're going to look at pivot tables. Pivot tables can be utilized to consolidate data into quick analysis. Last one I have for you is charts. Charts are a great visual representation of your data. Thank you for watching. I hope this helps you in the future when working with Excel or having to listen to people talk about Excel. Till next time, have an excellent day.